The City Worm and the Country Worm. Adapted from the Golden Book of the same name by Linda Hayward. Illustrated by Carol Nicholas. Featuring Jim Henson's Sesame Street Muppets in cooperation with the Children's Television Workshop. A Sesame Street Story. It's a bright, warm day. A beautiful day on Sesame Street. Oscar the Grouch is thrilled. Squiggly, one of Oscar's pet worms, has learned a new trick.
Hey, Squiggly, you're on. Oh, I can hardly wait to tell everyone about this.
Is the ladder set up?
Sure. I bet no one has seen a worm dive from a diving board into a thimble full of water.
Squiggly wriggles to the end of the diving board and looks down. The thimble looks very tiny.
Well, here goes nothing.
Squiggly takes a deep breath and... Squiggly's form was perfect.
Terrific dive! A few more practice sessions, and you'll be ready for the big time.
Good, but I don't have time to practice anymore now, Oscar. I have to go tidy up my room.
Tidy up your room?
My cousin Squirmy is coming to visit me tonight.
When my cousin Trashy visits me, I always mess up my room.
In the evening, Squirmy arrives from the country with her suitcase. The first person she sees on Sesame Street is Oscar.
Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for my cousin Squiggly. Does he live around here?
Yeah, right there, in that shoebox.
Oh, thanks. By the way, is it always so noisy in the city?
What?
I said, is it always so noisy in the city?
Oscar looks around Sesame Street. Cars and trucks are rumbling by. A garbage collector is rattling cans. A rock band is practicing upstairs.
What noise? I don't hear anything. When you live in the city, you get used to the noise.
Oh.
Cousin Squirmy, how nice of you to visit me.
Cousin Squiggly, it's wonderful to be here.
Welcome to the Big Apple.
Big Apple? Where?
Oh, that's just a funny name for the big city. We call it the Big Apple.
Oh, I see. I guess.
Squiggly takes Squirmy into his shoebox apartment and helps her unpack.
Squiggly, I love your room. You've got great taste in books. Those are great tie-dyed pillows on your bed.
The next day, Squiggly gives Squirmy a tour of the city. At the Earthworm Museum, they see 20 different kinds of dirt in the soil sample room.
What a colorful mobile!
It's called Worm Turning in Slow Motion. That makes sense.
Oh, Squiggly, look! A statue of Caesar Salad Worm!
And a painting by Van Gogh Worm. Gee, all this worm culture is really inspiring.
I've never seen anything like it in the country.
In the afternoon, they climb to the top of the Sesame Street sign and take in the view.
The city's a very exciting place, even if it is noisy.
That evening, they have front row seats at the biggest Earthworm musical stage show in town. In fact, it is the only Earthworm musical stage show in town. The next day, it is time for Squirmy to go home.
Everything, Squiggly. I hope you'll come to visit me sometime.
I've never been to the country. Do you have a lot of museums and shows?
No. We do have a lot of quiet.
After Squirmy leaves, Oscar shows Squiggly a sign. It says, "See the amazing diving trick. Come to the show starring Oscar T. Grouch."
I painted it myself. Terrific, huh?
Gee, I don't know. Can you dive into a thimble full of water?
Well, no. You're the diver.
Then why does your sign say starring Oscar T. Grouch?
Because I made the sign.
That is unfair. I am the diver, not you. I think I'll go on a long trip. You can do the show without me.
But.
As Squiggly packs his suitcase, he wonders where he should go. He remembers his cousin, Squirmy.
That That's it. I'll visit Squirmy. There'll be no shows, no signs, and no grouches in the country.
So Squiggly wiggles to the bus stop and waits for the bus to the country. When Squiggly arrives at Squirmy's address, all he sees is a big apple lying on the ground.
Gee, where's Squirmy's house? I must be lost. What was that?
Cousin Squiggly. Cousin Squiggly?
You startled me. I think I heard a bird.
Of course you did. There are lots of birds here. What a surprise to see you. How nice of you to come.
It's wonderful to be here.
Welcome to the Big Apple. That's what I call my house.
Squirmy lives inside a real apple. Squiggly loves it.
I like the patchwork quilt and the sampler on the wall.
The next day, Squirmy gives Squiggly a tour of the countryside. The cousins wriggle to the local puddle and take a brisk dip.
Hey, Squirmy, how many inchworms does it take to make a foot?
Gee, I don't know. 12?
None. Worms don't have feet.
That night, they sleep under the stars, with leaves of red and green and gold for blankets.
I have never seen so many stars. There's only one problem. I can't sleep. It's too quiet. If only Oscar were here. He makes a lot of noise. Then I could go to sleep. Oscar would play me a grouch lullaby, and it would be just loud enough to put me to sleep.
In the morning, Squiggly and Squirmy are talking about this and that, when a robin sitting on the branch of an apple tree notices them, and he's thinking about only one thing, breakfast.
This is the life, Squirmy. No cars, no trucks, no garbage collectors. The hole just in time. What was that?
That's just Robin Redbreast.
You've seen him before?
Oh, yes. When you live in the country, you get used to birds.
Mm-hmm. Cousin, it's time for me to go home. I guess I'm just a city worm. I like living in the city.
And I guess I'm just a country worm. I like living in the country.
Goodbye, Cousin Squirmy. Thanks for everything.
So long, Cousin Squiggly. Come back soon.
When Squiggly arrives home, he's surprised to see a sign hanging on Oscar's trash can.
Welcome home, Squiggly. Oh, that makes me feel good.
How's the wandering worm?
Tired of dodging birds and riding buses. But I like your sign.
If you think that sign's great, check this one out.
See the amazing diving trick? Come to the show starring Squiggly T. Worm. Gee, that's swell. But, I have something else in mind.
Oh, see the amazing diving trick. Come to the show starring Squiggly T. Worm and Oscar T. Grouch. But, Squiggly, you're the star.
Well, not without you, Oscar. That's what friends are for.
And that's the way things are on Sesame Street.